out first. Because that's the knowledge. Like the God said, when he came at the Garden of Kasim, right?
Kasim.
Mm-hmm. You know, when he manifested the law with the mind and the physical, was an Asiatic black man. Because that's the thing that we don't even see is our mind. The mind and the brain is two different functions, right? The mind and the brain is not the same thing, are they? They're two different, right? Mm-hmm. Definitely. You know what I mean? So now what we're talking about is this knowledge. What is this knowledge going to do for me? What is this knowledge going to do to you? Is this knowledge going to put money in my pocket? I'm going to tell you no. Because that's not what this knowledge itself is for, to put money in your pocket. You go get a job to put money in your pocket. You understand me? This knowledge itself is for you to get it for yourself. To learn about yourself. To know about your ancestors. To know what happened to us. So that we can shake those mental chains off. Because the physical change is not holding us back no more. It's the mental change that's holding us back. It's the devil's religion. It's the devil's holidays. You know what I mean? We honor a woman, true indeed. This is the day that they honor the mother. You know what I mean? That is something nationally within America. You know what I'm saying? And it's something that we should honor because they earth. We honor the earth on the Earth Appreciation Day. Appreciation Day, pardon me. You know what I mean? There's other days that we honor the woman also. Some of us don't even know your own mother's birthdays, but you can tell me the father-in-law born day. Some of you only know your own kid's born day, but you can tell me something about old man Justice. You can tell me about these different people, great men of the past, but you don't even know nothing about your own personal cipher that's going on in your own personal life. You understand what I'm saying? And this is the reality of being real with one another. This is what the 5% nation represent. It represents realness. It don't represent that fakeness, dealing with the belief and the mysteries and all this different type of thing that we've been made to believe. We not no gang. You understand what I'm saying? We not no bunch of group of people that jump you in and jump you out of. You understand what I'm saying? That's not how we operate. Now the God said he manifested in God wisdom. So that's good history that we was trying to find out, Naheem. Kasim, follow me, God. Kasim, you know what I mean? The history of some of the true borns upstate here. And you going back to God wisdom, that bad witness of what we was talking about, through the God, we was talking about gathering up some of the true borns here that go back before. My year one is 85. Your year one was 72. You understand what I'm saying? So we need to get the elder gods that's in this town here to show what it was like, you know, what some of the things the gods was doing. When it hit the free cipher. What's, you know what I mean? How was it going back in the 70s up into the 80s? You know what I'm saying? That kept this knowledge alive. So that's some good history, y'all. You know what I mean? I got knowledge in 85. You know what I'm saying? And I know for a fact that there's many gods in this town, old and young. You know what I mean? Sisters that was taught by their gods. You understand what I'm saying? But we don't see them, you'll never know they exist. You know what I mean? So it's like this, y'all. What are you going to do with this mathematics? What you going to do with this Islam? Not the Islam as a religion, because that's not the Islam that we're dealing with. We're not telling you that Allah exists in the sky, and Allah exists everywhere. We're saying that Allah is seen and heard everywhere on 196,940,000 square miles of land and water. We're saying that that's the original man. That's the original woman. That's the original children, because Allah makes up all of us. All together. See what I'm saying? So it's not something that we want to deal with lightly and think we just here to hear people get up and talk and regurgitate what we study or what we know. That's why we ask y'all questions. You know what I mean? Because we want to get y'all involved in what's going on here. This is like, you know what I mean, therapy for all of us. You know what I mean? We update you on what we're doing in this city. You know what I mean? Our plans in the future. We got a baby's day coming up. We got the Sean Prue going coming up next month in June. So there's a lot of activities that's going on. Bake sales that's going on today, right? Bake sale. You know what I mean? So there's a lot of things that we going on in the city. You know what I mean? That is positive and dealing with growth and development. And you won't know that, you know what I mean, until you see the works manifest. You know what I mean? And this is like when we meet here, this is a part of the work. When you see us out in the community, that's a part of the work. When we out in different seminars, sitting amongst other organizations, we sat with ARMS. over at Monroe High School, they had a forum on racism. And the forum on racism was, what is, who is a racist, or what is racism, and how does racism affect you individually? Me and the guard, Rob Bourne, sat on that. You know what I mean? That was at Monroe High School. And it was very powerful, you know what I mean, in that it showed and proved that the condition of our people was so lost that it was more Caucasians at the meeting than it was original people. You understand me? You know, so now you're in a forum on racism, and I was at one particular table where the whole table in my group was all white. So now me being who I am, the original man, knowing what I know, when I'm sitting there, all these devils sitting at the table, and they looking at me like, you know, what you gonna say, you know what I mean? And they were saying different things. One white guy said racism was human nature, and we had to shut that down quickly, because it's not human nature, because it's not something that you are born with naturally. Racism is something that you are taught, and it's something that is privileged by a group of people that has power and have control. That's the only way that you can be a racist. If you have power and you have control. Black people are not racist. You might be prejudiced, but you ain't a racist. It's not a racist bone in your body. You see what I'm saying? Because we don't have the power and we don't have the control. But the people that have the power and the control, the people that control the religious institution, the people that control all the images of angels and white, the Last Supper, white people, all that type of stuff. You understand what I'm saying? These are the people that hit our people in the head. And their children. And that was a part of the discussion. That was part of the discussion on the racism topic. You know what I mean? Because when it was discussed and everybody came up from their group and said, gave the brief summary of what was discussed in the meeting, you had different things that was coming out of there. But me and the guard, Rob Bourne and Howard Eagle, you know what I mean, who's like the chairman or the chairperson of the arms organization. And what he did, he sparked a lot of, he went to every group in particular just to spark, because people wasn't really trying to tackle it. They was trying to tiptoe around it. You know what I'm saying? And then when he sat down in the group and sparked up the real issue of how this racism thing really affecting us, or it sparked up a lot of people's mind. But it educated a lot of people also at the same time. You know, one guy came out of there, he was talking about the Bible. He was talking about, well, again, God, you know, it sounded crazy, you know what I mean? And, you know, he got bombed real quick out of there real quick, you know what I mean? So the whole thing is that when you see the stuff that is affecting our people, man, we got a lot of work to do in a short period of time. Life is too short, it seems like, you know what I mean, for the amount of work that we got to do. And the rate of the speed of our people, you understand what I'm saying, the condition of our people, where they at back then, it's only bad witness that we got a lot of work to do. And the ones that we really need to get is the women and the babies right here. You see what I'm saying? Because the older people is kind of like really lost. You see what I'm saying? And this is why we not really successful, God's on earth, because we ain't really been focusing on the young. Now, we ain't really been focusing on the young. You understand what I'm saying? Like we ought to be. Like, because like how the father did, when you look at the history and you see Bismi, you see Black Messiah, you see Yoruba, they was 16, 17 years old when they was around the father. They was young boys, you understand what I'm saying? That grew old in this nation. Umar Law, they in their 60s. ABG, Allah Be God, number 7, they in their 60s, 70s. Abu Shaheed in the 70s. You understand what I'm saying? So they started off young, except for Abu Shaheed, because he wasn't one of the 9 borns. He was one of the associates of the father, who was really tight with the father. So when you study the history of this nation, he was focused on the young. You understand what I'm saying? He focused on the women. That 23 million square miles that we talk about in the lesson. How much useful land is used by the original man? How much useful land is used by the original man?
23 million square miles.
Yeah, you know what I mean? See, that's another thing, you know what I mean? We got to be on point, God's urge. We got to be on point right now, man, because we don't really understand the seriousness of infiltration. We think because J. Edgar Hoover died in 1972 at 77, whatever, however old he was, we think that the COINTELPRO is not alive in this nation or alive in our community. So now, how is the COINTELPRO alive in the community?